Hey, welcome to the video tutorial Web Design 101. As you might have guessed from the name, this tutorial is for people brand new to web design who haven't done anything more complicated on the web than tag their friends on Facebook. We will explore the basics of three technologies, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and how they fit together to form the backbone of the web. So let's get started. The files used in this tutorial are available on GitHub with the link provided. Please download them if you'd like to follow along. You've probably heard of HTML. Every web page is a bunch of HTML tags, also known as elements, in angle brackets where you define all the stuff, like the text, images, links, text boxes, dropdowns, buttons, that is going to be on your web page. The tags are nested to define logical sections of the page, and the tags are usually intuitively named so you don't have to guess what they do. For example, this top tag tells the browser that this is HTML. You might be thinking, wow, really? But this is to distinguish from something different like XML, which is the format for the news feeds you see in every blog site. The whole rest of the page is just more tags. We will take a look at the head tag in a second, but for now, let's focus on the body tag. Inside the body tag is where all our user interface elements are. The header tag, shockingly, defines the header of our web page, where in real life you might find a navigation bar. But to keep things simple, we just have an image. This Img tag is how we add images, in this case the video logo. Outside the header, these H1 and H3 tags are for headlines where text is bigger and bolder. These P tags for paragraph are where we put text. Let's scroll down a bit. The A tags are for anchor, which is another term for a hyperlink to another page. And finally, the input tag is how you create text boxes and buttons. As you can see, we have a button at the bottom of the page that says, "Show me something." There are two important things to keep in mind. First, all we have done is define the stuff that's going to be on the page. We haven't said anything about colors, fonts, dimensions, margins, or anything else that will make the page pretty. Second thing, HTML is not code, although a lot of people say it is. Code is instructions you've written in a programming language that will actually do something. All we have done with the HTML is lay stuff out. So let's take a look at the web page in a browser. Okay, well, everything's there. The image, the headlines, the text, the button. But it is not pretty. The image is huge, the text is all over the place and with a lame font, there are no colors, the button looks bland, and when I click it, nothing happens. CSS, or cascading style sheets, is how we make our web pages pretty. In a style sheet, you list what are called selectors representing HTML elements, and then we describe the styles we want to see whenever the browser encounters an element that matches that selector. If that sounds confusing, hold on. We are going to use three style sheets to solve all the problems on this web page, but the cool thing is we only need to write one. As a web designer, you'll learn to borrow from the great open source work others have done to make your life easier. The first style sheet we will use is from Google to give us the Droid Sans font to apply to our page. The second style sheet is from the Twitter Bootstrap project, which was created by two guys at Twitter to provide web designers with a lot of goodies out of the box. For our purposes, Bootstrap adds some basic formatting to our page and some flair to the button. The last style sheet is a custom one we've created with some simple selectors. Let's take a look at that. As you saw earlier, every web page has an HTML body element, and this body selector at the top of our style sheet defines a style for our body element. In this case, it applies the Droid Sans font to the body, and therefore to everything on the page since it is all nested inside the body element. The header selector says that any time you find an HTML element called header, which we do have as you saw earlier, give it the video red background color and center everything inside of it. The Img selector says any time you find an Img tag, remember our web page only has one image, the logo, give it certain dimensions, background color, some space around it, and rounded corners. The other selectors work in similar fashion, but let's take a closer look at the A selectors. Remember, the A element in HTML is how we define hyperlinks. With CSS, we can define the color of our links in any situation, when the link has never been clicked, when you hover your mouse over the link, and when the link has been visited, meaning it was clicked before and is now part of your browser history. To apply all the styles in our three style sheets, we just need to add them to our web page. When we looked at the HTML on our webpage earlier, we skipped the head tag, but that's exactly where we add link elements to let the browser know where it can find our style sheets and apply them accordingly. Now let's take a look at the same webpage with CSS styling of our original HTML. Now that looks a lot better. We have some nice colors and spacing, the rounded corners in the image are a nice touch, the Droid Sans font from Google is a nice improvement over the browser default, and the Twitter Bootstrap style applied to the button is nice. The button style even changes when I hover over it. We get that for free from Bootstrap. But the button still doesn't work. In order to make a web page do things, you have to write code. HTML and CSS are not programming languages you code in, but the programming language of the web is JavaScript. In order to make our button do something, we need to write a little JavaScript code and add it to our web page. We won't get into detail, but this code uses the beloved jQuery library, another great open source project, to make it very simple to find the button and tell it to change the color of the text of the page from the default black to the color Vidya blue when it's clicked. Not the most exciting thing ever, but it gets the point across. Just as with our CSS from earlier, we need to add the JavaScript code to our web page. Again, we do so inside the head element, the same place where we added our CSS. Once we do that, we can return to the web page. Let's click the button. Now it actually does something. It turns the color of the text Vidya blue just as we wanted. And with that, we have a complete web page integrating HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Let's summarize. Every web page is built with HTML, and you create HTML tags to lay out the structure of your page. You use CSS to define how all the HTML is going to look, and you write JavaScript code to bring your web page to life and make it do things. If you haven't already, don't forget to download the files used in this tutorial from GitHub and explore these technologies for yourself. You will never learn technology listening to someone talk. Getting your hands dirty is the only way to do it. We really hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned enough to get started on your own web design work. We just scratched the surface here. HTML, CSS, and JavaScript are all rich topics, and we will explore all of them in greater detail in future tutorials and blog posts on the Vidya website. We hope you will check those out too. Thanks for watching. This has been Web Design 101 by Vidya.